Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Sandeep Gowte. I welcome you all to my YouTube channel English Guru for All. Dear friends, today we are going to talk about the most important nonverbal code, that is proxemics. Dear friends, already we talked about two nonverbal codes. They are, one is chronemics, and second one is artifacts. We discussed both in the previous video lesson, and now we are going to discuss the third one, that is proxemics. It is very important nonverbal code. Now what does it mean? As we already discussed that, chronemics means manipulation or utilization of time factor in the communication process. And artifacts means utilization of or influence of man-made objects on the communication process. Now we are going to talk about proxemics means what? That is proximity. What is it? Proximity. What is the meaning of proximity? That is the nearness or the distance. There are two types of distances. One is physical distance between the sender and the receiver, and second one is what? That is the cognitive level distance or proximity. Now this concept is very important to understand, because according to that we are giving the space to the, you can say, the participants of the communication process. Now on daily basis we communicate with each other, and according to that we are trying to maintain or we maintain the distance between other people. Now, what is that exactly? Now, let us discuss about it. Already I wrote here that proximity, or it is also called as what? Nearness, and how distance can be maintained between the sender and the receiver. Now, the term, which term? The term proxemics was coined by the anthropologist Edward Hall. So, he coined this term. Now, what does it mean? It is associated with the physical distance. What is that? It is associated with the physical distance between the sender and the receiver. So in the communication process, the sender and the receiver are there, and how much distance they should maintain between them, that is nothing but what? Proxemics, or application of this particular kind of nonverbal code. Now what does it mean? It depends upon what? Already I wrote here, it depends upon the relationship between, it depends upon the relationship between the sender and the receiver. Now we need to understand their relationship, means whenever you are going to communicate with someone. Suppose you just consider my own example. If I would like to communicate with my students, I know they are my students, and that is the formal kind of relationship, and according to that I am going to maintain the distance. Now what is the next one? That is cognitive level. We are talking about proximity or nearness on two levels. One is related to physical distance, and second one is related to cognitive level, means mental level. What can be that? That is mutual understanding between the sender and the receiver, and attitude of the sender as well as the receiver, and sharing ideas, even that is very important. At your cognitive level, mental level, what you want to share with others, that is also important, and that is called what? Sharing ideas. You need to keep in mind, we are talking about two levels. One is proximity of physical distance, and second one is cognitive level. Now let us move to the zones of distance. It is very important part. Everyone should understand this one. I am sure that your concept of proxemics is clear here. Now zones of distance, on the basis of this concept, Albert Mehrabian. Now there are actually four zones of distance which are made by this person. Now, which are these zones? These zones are intimate zone, personal zone, social zone, and last one is public zone. Now, please do not get confused. As you are saying that zones are given, it doesn't mean that you should take the scale for the measurement. Okay, you are in the intimate zone. Let me measure the distance first and then I am going to start the communication. It doesn't mean that at all. It means approximately he has given the distances here. Different distances are given, set of distances. Now we are going to discuss about it. What is the first one? That is intimate zone. What is intimate zone? Intimate means close relationship. And he has given, that is 15 centimeter to 45 centimeters. So that can be the approximate distance. And where only intimate people like what? Parents, children, relatives, close friends, and spouse, you can say. And spouse, they can enter only in this zone, others cannot. Now there are again two phases, they are made here. One is called what? Close phase, and second one is called what? Far phase. Now what is the close phase? That is less than 15 centimeters. If you are maintaining the distance less than 15 centimeters, that is called close phase. And if you are maintaining a little bit more distance, that is, you can say 15 centimeters to 45 centimeters, that is called far phase. So this is about intimate zone. The distance is given. Who can enter in this particular zone? It is already I mentioned. And what is given there? This zone is very important for embracing, touching, and whispering. These three aspects can be there: embracing someone, touching someone, whispering someone, saying something to another person, that is called whispering. And personal zone, now we are moving to next one, personal zone. What is it now? We are moving from intimate zone to personal zone. Personal zone, the distance is 45 centimeters to 120 centimeters. This is also used for the interaction between the good friends as well as family members, and they can be the part of what? Personal zone. Now again, there are two more phases. One is a close phase, another one is far phase. What about close phase? That is 46 centimeters to 76 centimeters. This is approximate distance, please try to understand. This is just the categorization made by Albert Merband to understand the concept of proxemics as well as different zones of distance according to relationship between the sender and the receiver. Now, they can be used for what? Friendly interactions and social gatherings or parties. At that time, personal zone can be utilized. Like what? Friendly interactions, then social gatherings and parties. They may involve personal zone. What is the next one? That is social zone. It is also very important. In social zone, what is the distance? That is from 1.2 meters, not centimeters, keep in mind. Here we discussed in centimeters. Now it is in 1.2 meters to 3.5 meters. Now in between they are going to have some distance, and again there are two phases. One is a close phase and second one is far phase. What is the close phase? If the distance between the sender and the receiver is 1.2 meters to 2.1 meters. What about the far zone? Far phase, that is 2.1 meter to 3.5 meter. Now, who can enter in this particular kind of zone? Zones of business transactions. It is called zones of business transactions. You are just, you can say, acquainted to someone. If the sender and the receiver both are acquainted to someone, in that case it can be used. Now what is the next one? Public zone. It is very important, public zone. Now what does it mean? It is beyond 3.5 meters. Now when can it be used? If you can say, if somebody is going to addressing a large number of people. Is many people are there. If the politician is delivering a speech, at that time you can see the distance that is maintained between the stage of the politician or that speaker and the public, those who are over there for listening to that person. Now again there are two more phases. One is close phase and second one is far phase. Now what does it mean? Close phase is, it is between 3.5 meters to 7.5 6 meters. And what is the far phase? That is 7.6 meters onwards. Now these are the two phases in public zone. Already I told you that it is used for what? If somebody is going to address a large number of people, many people are involved in this kind of zone. Now all these are the zones of distance which are mentioned by Albert Mehrabian. Now let us come back to again, I am going to revise this concept, the non-verbal code, that is what? Proxemics. Now what is that? Proximity or nearness or distance. The term was coined by Edward Hall. It is associated with the physical distance between the sender and the receiver, as well as it depends upon the relationship between the sender and the receiver. And what is there? It is also considered as the cognitive level. Means the mutual understanding of the sender and the receiver, then attitude and sharing ideas. And four zones are given by Albert Mehrabian. They are intimate zone, personal zone, social zone and public zone. Thank you so much. I hope your concept of proxemics is clear. I request you all to subscribe my YouTube channel English Guru for All and like the video and share the video, and please press bell icon for the latest notifications. Thank you so much.